There are artifacts found in various parts of India known as Shiva Linga. They are egg-shaped stones, sometimes found in objects resembling elongated bowls. They are nearly all found near bodies of water. Please locate these. They're called Shiva Linga. Egg-shaped stones, sometimes found in objects resembling elongated bowls. Shiva Linga.
We have this also in those that are held in hands, you'll say.
Yes. Briefly, what were these Shiva Linga used for?
This would be the cradle of creation. It would be a reminder of the creative forces. In different religions, there would be used symbols to remind the believer of their religious views. These were to remind those who would be initiated or aware that mankind has within itself the creative force. These would also be used as touchstones or here healing places, for they would be initiated or here blessed by the religious, let us call them priests at the time. And each day they were continued to be remembered. And as for this particular shape, it would be that as to a symbol of life, that humans have within their hands life, the ability to procreate, but also the ability to maintain their life, and that God is the creative force. So in essence, they are symbols of God, the creative force in the universe, which all things are created by this presence of God. They were also used as touchstones or places in which there could be some feeling or transference of life force. Those who would be sick would go and rest under the same, would be in states of meditation, would touch them, you'll see, and they would be benefited from this source or from this influence, you'll see. But as to that of the modern understanding, it would be to think of it as having God in your hands, witnessing creation, a plant growing, a cob of corn increasing, see, from a single seed. This is the miracle of life. Humans do the work, prepare the field, plant the seed, but it is God that gives the grain its life and gives the gain to the plant, that it can duplicate itself. Think of it, one kernel or seed from a cob of corn, plant in the ground, and 60 to 90 days later, an 8-foot plant with multiple cobs has been reproduced. How did that happen? It was the creative force that gave the gain. It was the force of God, life, you'll say. And therefore these would be testaments or remembrances or statues, if you will, that would remind the faithful that they have God in their hands, or God is in their hands, and they are in God's hands. Wherever you see creation, you see God. And this goes back to the beginning, when it would be the understanding of those who would be in the heavens above, who would visit the earth below, and create the race, or races, you'll say, seeding the planet. We finish for the present. The body should be awakened.